Mike Kelminski of Waves describes how his interest in oyster gardening grew from his experiences on a Chesapeake Bay skipjack in an interview with Susan West.
The last day I went out, the bay had frozen. The ice was about a foot thick. And we were out in open water, and when it was time to come in, we couldn't get back in. There were several other skipjacks out at the time as well, and the state sent in an icebreaker so we could get back into port. The boat that I worked on, last I heard a couple of years ago, was in the water in a little town in Virginia called Kinsale, Virginia. It's on the western shore of the bay. I did get a fascination for oystering because on the Chesapeake Bay, they're only growing in certain areas. And up there, you would have a depth sounder, and you're looking for these, you know, you're going across a level bottom, and then when you come across a lump, the oysters are usually growing on those lumps because they're elevated somewhat off the normal bottom. But I went to an oyster conference in Morehead City, I think it was in 2004, and I hooked up with other people of like-minded interest. The state, you can lease bottom from the state, but you can also lease water column. So the guys that are growing oysters in the water column are getting a 3-inch oyster in a year.
So how do you elevate them? What do you do?
Well, I guess you'd have some kind of a system where you're hanging them in cages or floating cages. If you have algae problems, you can lift these things out and dry them out. But, you know, then little crabs and critters, all kinds of stuff is intermingling in there with them. And some of it good for the oysters, some of it not so good.
Right. Tell me a little bit what happened with Hurricane Irene.
Irene, I was concerned because we had a 12-foot or a 10-foot surge from the Pamlico Sound.
Yeah.
And of course, we were up to our necks here in cleaning up and fixing damage and all that. And I was thinking, gosh, you know, it's not going to be much left. But, you know, I went back there and it was like nothing ever happened because
really
there was, you know, 10, 12 feet of water over top. Well, they're generally in 2 feet of water, so there was 12, 13 feet of water. That's the turbulence was well above them, so they were fine.
The oyster gardening, is that a hobby with you?
Yeah, it's a hobby. And it's become part of a photographic subject. I've enjoyed documenting it. Of course, each oyster shell is individual, like a human fingerprint.
Uh-huh.
There's no two that are exactly alike, but I've gotten fascinated with the patterns and the colors on them, and I've done some close-up photography.